Now, temporary permeability is also a very important factor. As I told you, endothelium is a very versatile thing. Endothelium has multiple qualities, you know more about it. So what happens if there is a bacterial infection? The bacterial toxins, they change the temporary permeability, and that leads to excessive amount of fluid transfer. Secondly, because of physical trauma also. Okay. So all that, besides that, in this tissue factors, the sodium retention also is an important factor. Sodium and water retention, that happens because of some disease process. That also leads to edema, and that is because of a change in osmotic balance in the tissue. Now, we come to the, this is a cartoon which shows why the lymphatic channels, they lead to severe edema. I hope you can understand. Early morning sleepy. Now, why the hydrostatic pressure, why the capillary pressure to increase? These are the reasons. Congestive heart tardive failure. Now, these conditions are itself related to particular pathology in the heart. Congestive cardiac failure. It's a cardiac failure because of cardiac reasons, right? Some pathology in the heart. But that leads to increase in the hydrostatic pressure, that leads to edema. Okay. Conceptive pericarditis, where the pericardium is inflamed and it undergoes some fibrotic change, it leads to constriction, increasing the hydrostatic pressure. Liver cirrhosis is a very serious condition where, because of alcohol, because of dietary problems, the liver undergoes fibrosis, shrinks, and that physical change in the liver leads to. So all these reasons are basically responsible for increasing the hydrostatic pressure, leading to edema, reduced osmotic pressure. As I told you, when the albumin is down in quantity, reduced in quantity. Nephrotic syndrome. This is a syndrome which is mostly affects the children. The children, if you see a small child walking inside a pediatric ward, whole body swollen with a big swollen face, that means something wrong with the kidney. The kidney membrane disease leads to excessive transfer of albumin from kidney to the urine. Excessive albuminuria, that is known as. So huge amount of albumin goes out from the body of that child, and therefore the oncotic pressure goes down. When the oncotic pressure goes down, lot of edema takes place. Okay. Liver cirrhosis. Liver is a factory of proteins. In our body, proteins are synthesized in liver. So when the factory is closed, how can the product be available? So no albumin because of liver being sick. So reduce albumin in the plasma and lot of edema. Can you understand? Malnutrition, many parts of the world, they have such a poverty that the children don't get proper proteins. So less protein, so reduced protein in the blood, lot of edema. And protein losing enteropathy means there are some intestinal conditions where a lot of protein is lost. And therefore, the blood level of albumin goes down and lot of edema. So these are the changes which are very, very pertinent for the edema. Now, lymphatic obstruction, inflammatory neoplastic. And these are the reasons where the lymphatics are affected because of some infection or some cancer leading to destruction. Post-surgical means what happens? Patients of carcinoma breast, they are subjected for extensive surgery of radical mastectomy, where breast is removed along with lymphatics also and lymph nodes also. When that is done, that part of the skin which is having no lymphatics undergoes edema change, and it's a very common phenomenon in most post-mastectomy specimen. Post-irradiation is something which is not very healthy thing, but some cancer patients, they have to go through that process, but that is the treatment of choice. And that also damages the structure of lymphatic drainage, and that also leads to edema of that part which has been irradiated. Sodium water retention, as I told you, the excessive intake of salt. You might have heard that some patients who are having high blood pressure, they are advised by doctors, don't take much salt, reduce the salt quantity. Why? Because their sodium is already there and more amount of sodium will lead to excessive collection of fluid because of osmotic imbalance, and that is why, and it is mainly because of renal problems. The renal excretion of sodium is not sufficient, and that retention leads to edema. Then altered capillary permeability because of trauma or bacterial infection or allergic disorders, poisons. As I told you, subcutaneous edema, dependent edema. Many times you might have noticed some senior, it happens mostly with senior people. Even youngsters nowadays, one of the students, you have some senior batch, something like that. Throughout the day when you are working normally, in the evening you feel that you have edematous foot. In the foot part, you feel as if there is slight edema. That is a very normal thing in many persons. Nothing to worry, it is because of posture. When you are traveling in a bus for quite some time, you are sitting, and that happens, but it happens in an advanced stage most of commonly. Periorbital edema. What is meant by this? Periorbital means what? You should get used to these terminologies very soon. What is this? Is orbit. Around the orbit. Periorbital edema. Specific diseases cause specific type of changes. Hypothyroidism is a condition which leads to periorbital edema. Okay. Pitting edema, I told you, pitting edema, invex edema, the edematous part, when you put a finger, press upon it and remove your finger, it's still that pressure, small depression remains for a while, then after a while it becomes normal. That is pitting edema. Cardiac edema is because of heart, we'll talk about it, pulmonary edema, edema of the brain. All this is related to the particular structure which is involved in this. Subcutaneous, now see this example. Now here also you can notice, this lady's right breast was operated. Okay? And see, it is not only on the right side, even her left hand is showing edema. A lot of lymphatic channels have been removed during the surgery, and this is after healing that the edema is there, which is usually a visual phenomenon most of the post-mastectomy specimen. This is spelling that the same thing in diagrammatic, this lymphedema. Edema because of lymph channel being blocked is lymphedema, okay? A lot of lymph gets collected there. Then, see this. What is this? This, what is the result of pyelidosis? This is that huge, enormous enlargement of foot of a person because of pyelidosis, which had blocked the lymphatics, and for ages it went on leading to such a huge distortion. I have seen a patient of elephantiasis having on face. You can imagine half of the face. My God, you can't see the face, but the fellow was very happy. Because it doesn't cause much problem except for that look and that simple anatomical change. But his whole half of the face was huge and very distorted. So all that is a result of lymphatic obstruction because of a number of things. Just quickly understand this flowchart. Very simple. Heart failure means because of number of reasons. Rheumatic endocarditis, subacute endocarditis, lot of other reasons of heart disease. At this stage you understand this much only. The performance of the heart is compromised. Okay. So what happens? Reduced cardiac output. I hope you know what is meant by cardiac output. How much blood it pumps out. That is what is basic duty. So cardiac output reduced. Effective arterial blood volume is reduced. Why reduced? Because less amount of blood is being pumped by the heart. So cardiac output reduced. So overall flowing, availability of blood in the whole body is reduced. So renal perfusion also reduced. So what happens? This reduction in the effective arterial blood volume leads to triggering on of a particular mechanism known as renin angiotensin mechanism. That is through kidney, aldosterone. Now these hormones, they respond to the reduction in the renal perfusion. What happens when there is reduction in the cardiac output? Less blood flows to kidneys. When less blood flows through kidneys, automatic triggering on happens of the renin angiotensin aldosterone axis. That is physiology you have used to read. And that leads to retention of sodium in water, and that leads to edema, increase in the plasma volume. Heart failure leads to reduction in central venous pressure, increased capillary pressure. Because the venous pressure is reduced, the capillary pressure is increased and leads to transudation, means edema, formation, transfer of fluid. Then increased renal vasoconstriction because of reduction in the arterial volume. This reduction in the cardiac output leads to increase in the renal vasoconstriction, increased hydrostatic pressure, and all this leads to renal retention of sodium and water. There, the malnutrition that leads to ascites now. So this is the basically the heart function which is suffering, and that is leading to edema because of the normal metabolic responses in the body. Triggering on of renin, angiotensin, aldosterone mechanism is a very normal phenomenon, which is triggered on because of reduction in the overall renal perfusion. What is, do you understand the meaning of renal perfusion? Means the less amount of blood is passing through kidney per minute. That is renal perfusion. Then pulmonary edema, very complicated. You just remember this much at this stage. That there are very serious conditions. Most of them lead to pulmonary edema. Means edema inside the lungs. Lot of fluid collects inside the lungs and the patient is almost choked. And this is a very terminal stage of most of the toxic or shock-like conditions where pulmonary edema takes place and there is fluid present in the lung. Okay, all over the lung is, they say the person drowns in himself because his own fluid chokes his lungs and that leads to, this is the x-ray of a person having a lot of fluid inside. No, the fluid is indicated by this hazy, opaque. This opaque thing is lot of fluid inside. Microscopically, you see this lung. It's just a very high magnification of an alveolar border where you can see the alveolar. You have seen it last time also in the practical. A thick alveolar, a lot of congestion, RBCs, you can see. All this pink material on both the sides is fluid which is there inside. So, this is just a microscopic picture of a lung having pulmonary edema. Now there are all types of edema, cerebral edema, pulmonary edema. Cerebral edema means edema of the brain, mostly that happens after trauma. There is a serious car accident, the head is having a blunt injury, there is a swelling of brain and that swelling actually leads to death of the person. Or it happens that there is an injury of a particular part of head, there is a bleeding, to start with okay, nothing is wrong. That bleeding becomes a big clot and that clot presses on the vital center, patient dies. The stories are like this. The person played football very nicely, had a very nice match, scored 2 goals by his head kick, went back to his hotel, next morning found dead. Why? He didn't bother that he is so enthusiastically excited that he is hitting the ball very hard and that has put some pressure, some injuries in some part of the scalp, and that pain he could not realize because of excitement or something, because he took some medicine to sleep or something like that. And then there was small bleeding to start with. And that bleeding gradually became a big clot, and that big clot pressed because of this big volume, and then the person dies. So these stories indicate these are only because of cerebral edema. These are symptoms, projectile vomiting. A patient having cerebral edema has projectile vomiting, vomits very violently. Headaches are there, convulsions. You know what is convulsion? Have you seen any convulsion? I don't think you might have seen. Convulsion means a person falls on the ground, suddenly his hands start twitching, his eyes roll up, his tongue comes out, there's a lot of frothing from the mouth. Yes? What? I mean, I cannot understand this smile. You know that? Okay. So that was simple.